So God, use us in a mighty way. Yes. Allow us to shine so bright because we give all our praise and glory to you. You made this happen. I can't be braggadocious and say you've given me the best bride on earth. I love that woman.
Here I am, I'm still standing. Here I am, after all I've been through, I survived.
One time with one great voice tonight.
Night together in holy matrimony. LaVon, Patrice, Bracy, Esquire. Minister Adrian Ray Davis. What a glorious opportunity this is for us to witness the providence of God. As once again, God, in his providence, has brought together a man and a woman. Not to make them roommates, but to make them lovers. We thank God. Many of us in here have been a part of their journey through their formative years. So today, Adrian and LaVon, you don't come to make a contract. You come to make a covenant. In a contract, it says, I'll do for you as long as you do for me. In a covenant, it says, I'll do for you even when you don't do for me. Even when I don't want to do for you. So we come together today to witness the covenant of God in bringing you together. Now on a personal note, LaVon is my little sister. I've known her for years, reconnected back on the back lake on Rio Grande one Sunday morning after preaching for homecoming. I've been a part of your private thoughts, your private tears. I've heard what you wanted in a man. I heard the thoughts you told nobody else about what you wanted. Adrian is the manifestation that God answers prayers. God has given you a man that loves you. He has given you a preacher. Not that you always wanted one. He's given you somebody that walks in the steps, the greatest man you know next to Jesus, your father. What a joy it is for me as the elder brother of you and Randy to stand here today to say I'm proud I'm getting me another brother. To be a part of this wonderful experience. So it is with great pride that I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Forced to come to this place, that poet whose skin had been kissed by nature's son, Maya Angelou, called these yet to be United States. One of the things that could not be taken from us was the dignity and pride of our ancestry. We brought who we were from the Ivory Coast. It could not be redefined by disenfranchisement. It could not be stolen from us. By the disillusionment of those who tried to say that we were less than because of our skin. So one of those things that we brought was what they call the jumping of the broom. Really don't know where it got started. John M. Beattie, who was a great African philosopher, says that it is his belief that this started in the Asante tribe in Ghana. In the Asante tribe in Ghana, they would all gather in the village. There were several things about the broom that we don't really think about before they jumped. Adrian and LaVon, the entire village would have a broom. And they would wave it in the air first because it signified sweeping away the evil spirits that would seek to infiltrate the new marriage. There are spirits that would try to infiltrate your marriage. So today we don't have a room that we can wave our hands to wave away every evil spirit. So they would wave the broom, but then the griot of the village would come and lay it down, and there were several things M.D. said. There were several symbolic things about the broom. A stick would be laid from the broom representing the new home. The width and breadth and hearth of the broom would represent all of the scattered people. Then the handle of the broom represented Almighty God. So it was a symbol that they were sweeping away the old life, coming into a new life. It was symbolic that when they jumped, because we were always the people of faith, we didn't get religion when we got to America. We brought a religion with us. We brought a faith with us. And even when they would say to us in the slave church who we weren't, God the tailor said the Holy Ghost was transliterated in midair. And the slave up in the balcony would hear something different than what the slave preacher said. We were people of faith. So that when they jumped this broom, it was symbolic of a leap of faith, leaving the life of where they are, jumping into a life of the unknown, but knowing they were landing in the arms of God. So today, y'all leaving this life. You're leaving formative years. Y'all got deep faith. I know that. So today, when you take this jump, you are leaping not knowing where you're going, but you're knowing whose arms you're in. We don't know what the future holds, but we know who holds your future. So today, you take a leap of faith, as Paul Tillich says, knowing that your ground of being is the divine. But there's one other thing. When y'all take this leap of faith today, you're signaling to your parents. They still got access, but they don't have authority. You are now your own, one in spirit, one in aim, and one in purpose. And so, by the power invested in me by the state of Florida, as they lay down the broom and as a bishop in the Lord's church,
as a bishop in the Lord's church,
power of God. I acknowledge what he has done, the miracle of your life, a marriage.
The Lord that blessed me, the providence of God, I also acknowledge this marriage.
And now. By the authority of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, being the dead.
Yes, sir.
I officially,
yes,
pronounce you man and wife.
Yes.
Adrian Ray Day.
Yes.
You may salute your wife. LaVon, Patrice, Bracy, Dave.
Every praise is to our God. So sweet.